this is extreme fly fishing 2004 or 2003 or 2013, depending on which title school you get. This was a school project that I worked on from March 10th, I believe, until April 23rd, so just about 6 weeks. Yeah, so we were tasked with making a mobile game, and after some creative brainstorming sessions, we ended up with what you're about to see here. The player takes control of this little guy right here. His name is Al. He's a fisherman. He's not having too good of a day, so instead of fishing for fish, he accidentally hooks a seagull and goes off on a journey. It's not as gruesome as it sounds. But so I worked as a design producer, and also I composed all the music in this game. Most of the programming, or all of the programming actually, was done by Alex Beauchene, and each of the three sections in this game, the art was done by a different artist. These three, Tim, Kate, Mike. So let's get started. So we have this nice little tutorial without being too intrusive, so we'll get that. And you get hooked. You can tell I'm playing on a computer right now, but you can get the A and D keys to get the same effect of the tilting. The primary development device that we use was a Nexus 7, but we do have the game running on iOS. It uses Adobe Air, so it doesn't really run great on devices without like a ton of specs. So for better players, that's a way to kind of not lose your whole multiplier if you really built it up. So you go, that was a long shot. So long shots happen if you hook an object at 80% or higher of your max casting distance. And then boomerang shots happen when you hook an object on the rebound, like that. And you can get something called a nice save, which is if you are off the screen, an object as like your last ditch effort, you get a point bonus for that too. So yeah, and on the side here you can see we have a height meter. So the height, the higher you go, the higher this bobber goes up. And it also tells you how close you are to not only your record, but also the end of the current level. as soon as you saw that level transition slow down and showed you how much higher you have to go to the next level, it was a long shot. So it kind of gives you a nice indicator of where you are in the level and also where your record is. If you notice, I've gotten a couple boomerang shots, but it counted it as a long shot. It counted as both a boomerang and a long shot, so I just gave you the better one. So yeah, we have 9 different levels. It takes about 8 minutes to go through all 9. The higher you go, the longer the levels last, the harder they get. But yeah, so it starts off here in the space. It was just like stars and constellations and stuff. Then you get to like deep space, and it's kind of like more like wormholes and stuff. And then you get to alien territory, which has no spaceships, space whale, dune suns. And then you kind of break through the dimension, or you break through time and space, and end up in the fourth dimension after that, which is full of psychedelic background, flying buses, and sitar music. After that, you end up in the void, which is composed of white background, text, and modern art, and then you get to the ocean again. You end up at the bottom of the ocean, and when you finish, well, you can't really finish the game. Combos still go up, the point values are higher, and it's overall a bit harder than your first run through that first level. So the difficulty always goes up infinitely. The entire journey takes exactly a mile, so 5,280 feet. This was our attempt at making a mobile game. I think it turned out really well. We got pause, music volume controls. So that's Extreme Fly Fishing 2000.